Hey, what's going on, guys? Your boy Salty Boy just making some breakfast for the early morning start. We're going to the Keys today. Yes, we are. So we're gonna head out, get some bait, and probably stop at our little secret spot for some bait, and then hit the spot. I'm thinking about walking out a little bit further on the pier to see, you know, what's the difference, and we'll see what happens. Stay tuned, guys. Meet you guys out on the pier. Hey, what's going on, guys? Made it out to the spot. If you know, you know. You already know. Freaking man. It's fogging up from the AC. We got here pretty early because I want to walk out a little bit further out. See if we can get on a better bite with some mangroves or maybe some bigger muttons. But also, I want to see what the tide is, and the tide is falling right now, so we're going to start gearing up and fish that upcoming tide. So you see where it is. Hope you get on a good bite today. Be here till around like 12-1 o'clock. Try to get back before all the school zones, and if the bite's good, I might stay out even longer. So we'll see what happens. We got a couple showers out there, but weather forecast said it's supposed to move around me, so I always bring on a little raincoat. Got the frog togs, you know what I mean. I got my 4-pin spears with me. I got some pinfish, live pinfish, see if we get on a big mutton bite. And I got the trusty old ballyhoo, so we'll see what it is. We got a long walk ahead of us. The water's going out, so tide's falling, so it's pretty good. We'll fish this tide for a little bit and then switch it. And the tide switch and starts going back towards the bridge. Hopefully we can get on a good mango bite. So stay tuned, guys. I'll be right back with the setup. See ya. Hey guys, we're back. I just want to show you guys what rig I'm gonna be using for these mangroves. A lot of you guys have been saying, hey, what type of rig you use? Carolina rig, fish finder rig, whatever you want to call it. It's a basic rig, and it's really versatile too. You can catch any fish with that. Muttons, snappers, any type of fish. And it all depends on what type of size hook you're using, you know, what type of weight you're using. Out here, I like to use like 1.5 to 2 ounces. It gets it down, but it's not so bulky where the fish see it. So right now the tide's not moving that bad, so I'm gonna use 1.5 ounces weight. And all you're gonna do is take your main line and just put it through. Just like that. And most of the time there's a big side of the eye and a little side of the eye. The little side is supposed to go down so that way your knot doesn't go inside, but I still use a bead. Most people don't use a bead. I do. I like to, just to keep the weight away from my knot. So I got a little bead. Just put that on your main line too. Boom. Just like that. Next is your swivel. So I got a little, I think it's a 90 pound swivel, little tiny one. Don't need no bulky swivel. I'm not going crazy. Just put it through the eye, just like that. And it's just a basic knot. Grab your tagline and just wrap it around. I do about six to seven, depending on the thickness of the line. Wrap it around. This knot works for me. You guys have your own knots. I have 2 different knots I like to tie, but this one works for me the better. And you just put it where your swivel is. You got that little eye right here. Put it through, and then you make a loop like that, and then I put it back through, just like that. Simple. Wet it, tie down. Boom, that's your knot. Good morning, sir. And we're set. Slip off your tagline. Boom. All right, this is the most important part. Depending on the clarity of the water, is the size test you're gonna use for your leader. I like using, you know, for mangroves, I like to use 10 to about 15 pounds. Right now, since it's the morning, the big fish like to bite in the morning, I'm gonna use a 15 pound Andes mono. All right, I'm gonna use, since this rod is gonna be close, I'm gonna use about 2 feet, 2.5 feet of leader. Okay, I'm gonna do the same knot. Put it through the eye of the swivel. Grab about 6 inches of tag line and just wrap it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then put it through, back through the eye, and then back through the loop. Wet it, switch it down. Just like that. Clip off the tiger. Alright, so about 2 feet of leader line. And we're gonna be fishing next to the structure, but I also wanna give it that distance. I am going to use, mangroves out here are pretty big, and I'm going to use a decent sized chunk bait of ballyhoo. So I'm using the Mustad, what is this? The 3-0 Mustad. It has a little barge right here, so it helps keep the bait on. But that's 3-0 Mustad. I basically only use Mustad hooks. So you can go find them at any Walmart. Most of the stores down here have some hooks, and you most likely find Mustad hooks. I use the Mustad jig heads too, so that's what I use for my hooks. Same knot. Twist about 6-7 inches of tag line. Twist it around about six times. Put it back through the eye. Boom. Make the loop. Go through the loop. Wet it. Snitch down. Boom, just like that. Okay. So that's gonna be for ballyhoo, caught ballyhoo for my snapping rig. That's gonna be close up by the pillar, most likely right by the chum bag. I already got the chum bag out. And I like to get all my rods ready before I start fishing, because man, have I lost a lot of fish when I'm sitting here tying up a freaking knot, and next thing you know, I look over and my freaking rod is bent over, and I get over there and it's gone. So I like to first get all my rods ready and then start chucking them out. And I like to spray this Real Magic right here, because mono gets crispy when it's in the sun. So I just spray it on. It helps with the memory of the line. I mean, you guys know that use mono, it can get annoying. It's freaking starts bird nesting. So I'll be right back with the new rig that I'm gonna be trying out. Well, not new rig, but new setup I'm gonna be trying out. That's gonna be out here. Hopefully it works. I'm gonna be using live bait on it, the live pinfish, to see if we can catch some good barracuda, maybe hook into a tarpon. Hopefully it's not a big old tarpon. And maybe a big mutton. So I'll be right back. Another yellowtail. Where's the mangroves at? That's what I want. Yellowtails are okay. Well, yeah. Hey, calm down. Not of size, so I'm tired of catching them. A grouper. Oh, crap. First grouper. Oh, yeah, that's cool. Is that a black grouper? It looks like a black grouper. It sure does look like a black grouper. I want to see how big this guy needs to be. He got two needlefish head in his mouth. Fish rule comes in clutch. Where are we at? It's grouper season open. Come on. Grouper. Alright, black grouper. Open season, that would be a minimum of 24 inches. That is not 24 inches. Oh, come here. That's a good fish right there. That is a good fish, guys. That is a good fish. Let's see if we can get him in. Oh yeah, that's a nice size yellow tail. Oh no, that's a mutton. Oh, found the mutton. Love the mutton. I knew you'd be out there in that sandy spot. Still not good. Oh, look at that barracuda right behind his ass. Oh, nice mutton. And he's not choked. He didn't choke it, so that's a good thing. Yes. It's always mutton time. Ouch. God damn it. Ugh, look at that, guys. Nice mutton. Way too small. I'm gonna get him back. Alright. Let's get him bigger. They're there, but this need to be big. There's a barracuda that's swimming around here. I'm gonna try to catch him, see what happens. Oh, got one. Don't know what it is. Ah, she calls it a long time. Hey, give me a second, I'm finding a fish. You hear that? I said I'm finding a fish, give me a second. Come on, come on, you big fucker. Oh, I think it's a big mutton. I think it's a big mutton, babe. Come on, get up here. Get up here. Oh yeah, it's a big mutton. Come on, be a keeper, baby. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, I think I got a big mutton. I think I got a keeper. Come on, come on. Please don't break. Please don't break. Please don't break. Oh, yes. Woo! I got him. I got my mutton. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Woohoo! Yes. Hello?
Hello.
I got my mutton. I finally got my freaking mutton. Jesus Christ. Oh, I'm gonna let you know right now. Oh my gosh. Right where you called, you took off.
See, oh. I'm good luck for you.
I know, that's why your ass should be here. Oh man. Oh damn, he's right on 18. Oh yeah, that's a keeper. Oh no, he's 19. He's 19. No, he's 19 inches. He's legal. Yes. I wish. Oh no, he's dead on. Oh man, yes. Oh, 1 second. I'm a. Guys, guess what? Keeper mutton boy. Yes, no, it's the mutton time. It is a mutton time. Look at that mutton. He is 19 and a half. All the way. Man, you don't know. I've been searching for my keeper mutton for the longest. I'm so happy, guys. This made my whole day. They're eating. eating, and I kept missing them, and I just turned off the live runner, and sure enough, boy ate the pinfish. Yes sir, boy, let's go. All right, guys, that's all she wrote. I'm happy, so happy. Got my keeper mutton. So, and I got a yellowtail, nice 13-inch yellowtail. So that made my day. I did miss a couple big hits, but that's fishing, it happens. So it was a really good day, really productive day. I was out here for a while, but not too bad. Didn't catch any mangroves. I'm kind of upset that I didn't catch any mangroves. You know, I don't know if they weren't biting or I wasn't just targeting them as much, but oh well, it happens. But all right, guys, see you guys. I don't know what I'm doing over the weekend, but we'll see. Stay salty. Later.